What's going on? It's Anton from AntonDaniels.com. I appreciate you guys for continuing to rock with me. I'm out and about and I'm running errands and I'm taking care of business. But I just got off of a coaching call and I wanted to talk to you guys specifically about delayed gratification, because it's funny, this person I've been coaching for about 6 months, right? 6 months. And when I first got him, he was very, very caught up in making sure that he stays cash rich. How much money he can have in his bank account, how much money he'll have to be able to play around with. Worked very hard, very, very dedicated, and you know who you are, very, very dedicated to securing a bag, but had to change his mindset when it came to how it was he was using money and his relationship with money in general. And I find that so many people find this as a hurdle, and it takes a little bit of time for you to be able to transition your mindset over from looking at things when it comes to how much money you can have available versus how much money you have working for you. Now, it seems as though it's an easy concept, because it's like, oh man, I want to make investments, I want to get to the bag, I want to get rich, I want to have multiple sources of income, multiple streams of income. But it's easier said than done, because a lot of times, especially people that come from certain environments, they're not used to not having access to the money and the resources, letting it work from in a form of, I don't know, an investment, putting it into a long-term investment, a stock, a real estate, anything, right? People only care about cash flow, and cash flow for me does not mean anything. And I had to train myself to get away from that whole money phone mindset. How much money can I have in my hand at that specific time? And often at times it leads to less money in your pocket long term, because you have to look at your money as little employees. Every single dollar you earn, you birthed it, you traded in your time for it, and you need every last one of them employees to go out and get you more money. So here's the thing. Delayed gratification is the thing that most people have a hard time grasping when it comes to implementing these things, right? We want everything now. We want the purse now, we want the cars now, we want the vacations now, we want the women, and largely women want men now. They want everything now. And very rarely do you see somebody say that, you know what, it was worth it for me to work 10 years, hold it down for 10 years so that I can live the rest of my life the way I want to. Often at times we've been trained to have this YOLO mindset. You only live once. I don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow. I could be gone tomorrow. I can't take it with me. And so we use that to justify making bad decisions financially every single day, over and over. We don't plan for the future. I just read a report that said well over 40% of people that make over $100,000 a year, and I'm guessing that it's much higher, but I can't cite the source right away, but well over 40% that make over $100,000 a year is living paycheck to paycheck. How are you continuing to level up and live paycheck to paycheck? We continue to keep up with the Joneses. We often at times do things to impress people that have no bearing on us whatsoever. We buy things for people that don't give a piss about us. And so we don't have that level of delayed gratification, or we don't have the balance to be able to have the mindset to implement delayed gratification that is often at times going to work best for us. So let me tell you what delayed gratification does. It makes us appreciate things much more. It reminds me of a conversation that I was having with the Thinking Man's podcast, and I love that conversation. I always love that conversation, because we were talking about him buying his son a car. And I think that that was one of the videos or the clips that I posted that got the most reaction, because people were adamantly for it or adamantly against it. I believe in suffering. I believe that men need to suffer in order to be able to truly appreciate exactly the blessings that come along with being in a position of power, so on and so forth. But, you know, the fact that I had to work and my dad did not buy me a vehicle, but instead he gave me the tools and the insight to be able to acquire the vehicle, to acquire the bag. If you can teach your kids, if you can teach yourself how to be patient, how to wait. I was coaching my boy Sean, and he's a lawyer, and you know, Sean was telling me, like, Ton, man, all of my network and my friends, they out buying the Benzes. I gotta switch around. They out buying the Benzes, the BMWs, they doing well, they getting to the bag. I said, but Sean, how much money they got in the bank? He said, sometimes they be borrowing from me. How? He said they move a specific type of way that's not conducive to people that make that type of money. How? Meanwhile, Sean is over there with a completely paid off car, no more student debt. He is continuing to level up in his career. He's moving the way that he's supposed to move when it comes to his relationship and his chick. And he's not even 30 yet. He's so far ahead of the eight ball. And it's funny because when I had first took this executive position and I was talking to the big boss, and I was like, yo, how would you play it a little bit differently when it came to, you know, your career or whatever? And he tells me all the time, Anton, I would have invested more. I would have invested sooner, earlier. I would have got out of debt when I first started getting to the bag. But often at times what we find is that we get so excited about the fact that we've leveled up and we've made it and we get into the money and now. And so we want to reward ourselves. We want to automatically run out and go and get the Rolex. We don't want to wait until it's actually a milestone. We want to jump straight into balling as if to show the world that we made it. But that's all internal. It's here. I've stayed down for so long before I actually started to spend money. And one of the reasons why I didn't start spending money automatically is because I wanted to make sure that I was actually leveraging the ways in which I was supposed to spend money, and that it not only added value to what it was that I was doing from a business perspective, but to ensure that I was getting all of the necessary write-offs that I was supposed to get, and I wasn't actually taking money that I worked for and spending it recklessly and not letting that actually, you know, help me or benefit me when it came to my taxes or my businesses or anything like that. So my point is that we have to train ourselves from today going forward that we are going to do the thing that's in our best interest long term. When I make an investment, when I pick a stock, when I research a company, when I make a real estate investment, when I say that I'm never going to sell a property, even when it comes to my marriage and I say I'm never getting divorced, it's in my best interest to make a decision long term. We find ourselves making short-term decisions and paying the price for short-term gratification. You rocking with that girl tonight is often at times going to lead to regret in the morning. You're going to be trying to figure out how you got in that position. You're going to be trying to give her a plan B because you didn't even pick up a rubber. You just making short-term decisions every single day, and it's not best for you. You make short-term decisions regarding the people that you interact with. You make short-term decisions as it relates to your investments. You make short-term decisions as it relates to the things that you're going to buy in order to make yourself feel better. And then you justify it by saying that I deserve this. No, we deserve what we invest in and grind for. And it's not about how much money you make. It's about how much money you keep. It's not about who it is that you can get. It's about who it is that can hold you down. We got to change our mindset when it comes to the things that we value and how it is that we look at the different ways that we're going to move that's going to play a role in either our long-term success or whether or not we're just going to be regular and average or our failures, all right? So I just want to put that bug in your ear, a little bit of Porsche talk. So we riding, we going to go and take care of some business. I got to go and make a couple pickups, and then I got to stop at the post office to mail off a package or two, and then we gonna get to that bag. Alright, so I love y'all, I appreciate y'all. Make sure you hit a like for the YouTube algorithm. Patreon is in the description. Also, in the Patreon, I'm making investments in my people and in my members. So much information, so much game, so many mastermind sessions that is going up. So I appreciate everybody that hold me down in the Patreon. Shout out to everybody that tune into my live stream on After Hours. Make sure you subscribe to that channel. And then a Lapeef Network. It go up from there, and that's where the real fun and entertainment is. So make sure you subscribe to the Lapeef Network. All of those things should be down in the description. I love you guys. I appreciate you. I'm going to holler at you later. Peace.